Welcome back to my channel Orchid House. I'm Olivier in Fort Lauderdale and I wanted to continue my series on showcasing some of my Catasetums. And today we'll look at mostly species or primary hybrids or something close to a primary hybrid. My all-time favorite, there's an old video from 2 years ago that's dedicated specifically to this one. That's schmidtianum. It's a species from Brazil. I'm particularly proud of it because I think it's the best color you'll find for this particular species. And I don't know, I love it. The contrast between the red and the amber and the coppery colors. This is a very reliable bloomer, second bloom this year. 13 flowers. Last time I had 15. And the division with one single bulb started blooming right away as well, with two blooms the first year, and again this year it's doing really good. Then we move on to Catasetum Susan Fuchs. Now this one had a disaster. I dropped it yesterday, so it's badly bruised, as you can tell. So this is a good flower that's not damaged. It has a very thick lip, and if you can tell here, it's like it's in broken pieces because it's so thick. It still sticks together, but it's kind of odd. This is another reliable bloomer. So far this year, second bloom, I expect a third one. The negative with this one is that it triggers very easily. So you know that these little pollens here, they can trigger the slightest touch, and then the flower dies the next day. And these one lasts seldom more than 5 days. It's one of the shortest lived of my Catasetum that's not a species. So this one is actually 75% expansum and 25% pileatum, which are the two largest flowers of the genus. And talking of expansum, this is expansum, second largest flower of the genus after the pileatum, and it's very typical with a very flat lip. You see it across all the expansum that have very different colors, from white to yellow to green and others, so it's very varied. This one is Myra'HCC Sunset Valley Orchid Midori. I've had it for only 2 years, and this year it's already the second bloom, so it's going well. They're not going to last very long either. Then a real hybrid, and it has fimbriatum in the background. It's actually 50% fimbriatum. It's Hat Trick. Mine is green. I believe that most are usually in the reds. This is actually close to 2 weeks, I think, now, so it's not very fresh. It has an amazing fragrance. This smells like a cake, and the kind of cake that you want to eat. It's very, 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 very sweet. Very sweet fragrance. Beautiful plant. It has the lateral sepals that are always recurving pretty fast, so which is an annoying trait, I think, but anyway. And that's another very reliable bloomer, usually blooms 3 times a year. And then we'll finish today with Alexis Pardo. Huge flower, it's crossed between pileatum and tabulare. And this is also the second bloom this year. Another one that doesn't last super long, but quite an original flower. And if you know tabulare, you'll see that the callus here on the lip comes from that particular flower. Okay, that's it for today. Thanks for tuning in.